In general, preparing for weight loss surgery involves getting a good education about the various choices, picking a good hospital and a good surgeon, and also a program that's going to offer you support for the long term. All these operations work by helping control your hunger or your appetite, but you need support in not only doing those things, regular exercise, but also following up as to the various things that need to be checked, such as vitamins and minerals, or the position of any device that's put in. So you really need lifelong follow-up, a commitment by the center where you have your procedure to follow you in the long run is really important. Each operation works in its own way. The adjustable gastric band is a plastic ring placed around the stomach where we can change the diameter of the inside of the ring and control how food enters and leaves the stomach. So it provides a restriction to food entering into the stomach, slows down the passage of that food to help you feel full sooner after you eat. Sleeve gastrectomy is an operation that removes 3/4 of the stomach, and it works not only by making the stomach smaller, but also by removing some of the hormones that can impact your hunger and response to food. And gastric bypass not only bypasses most of the stomach, but also a portion of the intestine, thereby not only changing how your body responds to and digests the food, but how you absorb some of those things. So each one of these operations has a different mechanism or additional mechanisms by which it works. The bypass, having those three mechanisms, which is a small pouch to make you feel full, change in the hormones to make you less hungry, and change in the way you digest your food, is the most powerful of the general operations we do. And the band, which only has the restrictive component, is the least effective of the operations, with the sleeve somewhere in the middle. Well, deciding on which operation is right for you requires, again, careful education about the choices. Work with your doctor to talk about the medical problems you might have associated with your weight, and understanding what you bring to the table as far as your ability to make changes in your eating and lifestyle behaviors. I often say, you know, we give you a hammer. If you're not bringing nails to the table, you're not going to build anything. If you're bringing screws, you need a screwdriver. So it depends on who you are and what you can change in your life. People who eat too fast might need a different operation than people who eat the wrong types of foods, but slowly. So it's a very individualized decision that you make with your doctor. After weight loss surgery, you go through a diet progression. So early on, it'll be just liquids, then pureed, then soft, and eventually regular food. That's going to happen over the course of 2 to 6 weeks as you advance after surgery. So small amounts of food, rapid weight loss after, say, a sleeve or a gastric bypass where we're looking at 1 pound a day. And after a band, the weight loss doesn't get serious until the band is properly adjusted. You're going to come for monthly visits after a band, where we're going to adjust the band until we achieve the right tightness so that you're feeling full with small meals. So what you expect and what you're going to feel in your diet is going to change depending on which operation you choose. In order to ensure success of surgery, you really need to make a good choice of operation up front, a commitment to change long term, and the thing we know that works the best for long-term success is regular exercise. 40 minutes, 3 to 5 times a week of aerobic exercise is the best predictor of long-term success.